listen, we all know Photoshop and Facetune are a thing.
People do it.
People do it. Sometimes people overdo it.
Sometimes people do a little.
And then sometimes people do a lot.
Well, you know, we're not judging, though.
We're not judging, but we'll let you guys be the judge.
Yes.
Because we're going to talk about some of the most shocking Photoshop celebrity moments right here on Dirty Laundry.
I'm ready.
So this is Kylie Jenner and James Charles filming a makeup tutorial for Halloween. And you know, James Charles is not shy when it comes to telling people that he uses Facetune and Photoshop.
So the photo that she posted on Instagram and the video that she did with James Charles, she looks different than she does in the video than in the photo.
Right.
But she looks great both ways.
Yeah.
Her nose is a different shape.
Mm-hmm.
Her hair has been... like the color of her hair
is different.
It's like
her eyes are a completely different shape.
They're a different shape, but the shape of her face has been edited. Like the shape of her face in the picture is definitely not the shape of Kylie's face. I'm so confused by this.
Okay, my question for you is, Kylie, there was video proof you don't look like that, so why would you Photoshop your photo to look like that?
I think you just have to know that when you go on these apps, it's altered.
Right.
Just as when you look at a magazine or you look at a billboard, you know that's not the raw footage or the raw image.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just remember that. So don't let it get into your head.
When you have 200 million followers, you're serving art. Like, you're not just gonna throw up an unfiltered selfie like an uncultured swine.
That's
okay, so we have a picture of Ryan Reynolds and his lovely wife, Blake Lively.
Love their relationship so much.
So cute.
This was an exciting photo. I know he posted it because it was his first time voting in a US election. And that's really cool. And the first thing I noticed when I saw this was that he's wearing shoes and she's just like not wearing shoes. And then she posted a very similar photo, but with shoes on.
Listen, that is amazing.
I don't care if Blake Lively's shoes were fake. I don't give a rat's bum. I think it's amazing that she drew on not just any heels, but Louboutins.
Yeah. First of all, commendable job on designing the heels around the foot. On Photoshop, how did she do
that? I'm so intrigued.
Honestly, I think if you're gonna Photoshop anything, this is the way you do it. I think it's hilarious, and far away, if you don't zoom in, again, they look like she's really wearing high heels, and they go really well with her outfit.
This is a Photoshop I can get behind. One, because you're right, she drew a lovely pair of Louis Vuittons, authentic from the reason she did it to the actual shoes she would wear.
Yeah.
And just, they're just such a funny couple too, so it would make sense that he was like, I'm gonna post this before you even get a chance to acknowledge that you're gonna draw on your shoes.
Yeah.
It's just so funny. This, I can get behind this.
So Victoria Beckham posted this adorable photo of her son, who's newly engaged to the beautiful Nicola.
They look great, but it looks like they're like standing on top of the ocean.
It looks like they might have slapped this background to make it feel like that.
Oh my God, I really hope the original is like in front of, like they're in an alley.
You know what? You know what? See? What we're not gonna do is that, Victoria.
How do people do that?
This is the epitome of like a stage mom. She's like, oh my God, my baby and his girl looks so beautiful, but you know what? We can do better. We are the Beckhams.
Well, they can't because we all found out.
Oh my God! It's like literally an alleyway.
They're literally walking on water.
Yeah.
Like their feet are in the ocean. And if I
and
was
it's like disproportionate too. Like the ocean's very small. They're like giant people walking on the ocean.
I will say for the purposes of like, oh, engagement, so cute. Victoria's photo is better because it looks more romantic and it's like the moon or something. Is that the sun or the moon coming down?
One of them.
Something. It's a circle object.
Yeah. It's one of the things up there.
I think it's hilarious that ABC wants to cover up the girls when they're showing a little bit too much cheeks, but we've seen some like pretty intimate moments on The Bachelor and The Bachelorette. So I think it's funny that that's the one thing that they want to cover up. And it's obviously, it's just so awkward. Like, look how they made her butt look.
Wait, is this real?
This looks bad, though. Like, this is actually drawing more attention to whatever they were trying to hide than just putting a blur or a color bar or whatever they can put there, because this makes no sense.
Yeah, that's doing her dirty. Like, she probably worked out real hard to come onto this show and was like, perfect, here's my moment. Give me the cheekiest bathing suit you got.
Right.
And then they, like, straight up went on, like, Google Paint and just literally painted her ass. Like,
also, I don't think that this is good. This is not good if you feel the need to edit out some harmless butt cheek, but you don't feel the need to edit out Peter's
Peter.
Honestly, though, I think Peter was so distracting that I didn't really even notice the Photoshop on her butt.
Okay, Christine from the amazing show Selling Sunset. Mm-hmm. Girl can sell a house. Mm-hmm. She's not selling me on this Photoshop, exactly. No.
I know that she does stuff to her photos, but it doesn't matter because it's another thing. There's certain people that you follow.
Mm-hmm.
You know they know do stuff, they do but it looks photos. Good. Like, I see nothing wrong.
I absolutely love her, and I love her fashion sense. She is always put together perfectly.
As long as people are doing anything that's gonna mess with their mental health.
Right.
I don't see a problem with it because it's just like when you look at a magazine, you mm-hmm. know that that is not the raw image. So it's like Instagram could easily just be someone's spread.
I mean, whatever. She looks great in the video. She looks great in the photo. I don't think the photo needed to be photoshopped at all because I think she looked incredible. But also, if she wants to do that, then like whatever, let her live.
Khloe Kardashian. Listen, we all remember when this photo was posted. Mm-hmm. She looks gorgeous. And she looks gorgeous outside of this photo.
Honestly, somebody needs to teach me how to do Photoshop. Like, this is impressive.
Like, we know what Khloe looks like. It's the same thing. If she wants to put herself out there looking like snatched perfect, like filtered a little bit more, cool. Like, what? That doesn't change my day. So the fact that people always get so upset about stuff like this, it's like, who cares?
Clearly, there was editing done.
Yeah.
But again, I don't think she was trying to hide anything because this was literally her confessional look in the show. So yeah. We see video of her moving in this exact look, you know?
And I feel like she just gets so much flack no matter what she does.
Yeah.
And she's a gorgeous girl. And I just feel really bad that she felt she had to do this to her photo.
Yeah.
I'm sure Khloe laughed at the backlash because she's like, haha, you guys are still gonna watch my show and I'm still gonna get that coin.
Right.
So at the end of the day, you can talk about it all you want.
Mm-hmm.
But Khloe is cashing that check.
All right, more Kardashian fam for us. We have this photo that Kim Kardashian posted, I believe for her birthday weekend, wherever they were traveling. So it looks like Kim lost an arm in this photo. I have definitely tweaked little things here and there close to my body where your arm starts to like change its total shape. You've never?
I totally have done that, but I don't think this is a Photoshop.
Okay, so if she was the one who edited this, I don't know what removing her arm would do to this picture. I don't get it. So that's what makes me feel like her arm is actually there, but it's just bent upwards.
If you look like at the edge of the other girl's tricep,
like
you can
this.
See the shot. Yeah, she's literally like this. So she's doing like an upper angle. She's not doing like this.
Listen.
Goodbye. This
people
is stupid.
Have way too much time. Stop being
what
a hater.
What y'all doing? She's out there having fun with her friends and y'all over here talking about her arm.
I can, however, agree and understand why the masses are not very quick to believe that because Kim Kardashian has done a terrible job in the past of photoshopping her pictures and forgetting things like, I don't know, like half a car.
Okay, so we have this photo of the Kardashian Wests.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is hilarious. North was having a tantrum that day, and Kim was like, look, I'm just gonna Photoshop you into the photo because you're not acting right, and I think this is completely fair.
Honestly, as a mom, mad respect, girl. I understand. Look, liked by Sinead DeVries and 8.7 million others.
This is hilarious that it looks so real, and I feel like most families are gonna start doing this because it's so hard, especially when you have four children trying to wrangle them all in for a photo. It's just not happening. One person's gonna be crying, one person's gonna be looking to the left. So I feel like this is how you Photoshop.
I'm impressed.
She looks like she's there.
Because this, like, everything is on point. I will say the other children are looking directly at the camera. She's looking slightly off. That's the only thing that's throwing me off.
I didn't notice that.
Because Kim's looking too.
I feel like the Kardashians have had other Christmas cards where you can totally tell and it's been blatantly obvious and really distracting. This is not distracting. They're all wearing very neutral colors, which really helps. They're all having very different emotions here. I mean, the kids seem like pretty happy. Kim is looking out the distance and Kanye is thinking about running for president in 2020.
Listen, you guys, these apps are out there. These applications are out there, but you know what I say? Save yourself. Don't learn how to do any of it.
Mm-hmm. Don't do it.
Don't do it.
And just know that what you see out there in these streets and on the interwebs, it ain't real.
It's all a lie. It's all a lie.
Again, unless it's us, because I swear to God.
I mean, I facetune a zit out.
A little, but see, we remember the beginning. We talked about a little versus a lot.
Yeah.
A little goes a long way.
Yeah, just remember
that in life. That's a good message.
Have you ever had a Photoshop fail?
Mm-hmm.
Let us know, because you know what? You're human, we're human, and sometimes we don't want to look human. It is what it is.
Yes, and since you are human, use your human fingers to click that subscribe button, the like button, and leave a comment in the comment section below, because why? We love you.
We love you. Also, click over there, because there's more clever style where this came from.